preschool education, I have to point this one out because it's absolutely essential that the children of the poor get to preschool, because if they can't get to preschool, then the gap opens up with the rich people and that gap persists through life. And you can see from this graph that only about 60%, and the poorest people in our society, both in urban and rural areas, something like 50 to 60% of them are not in school, not in preschool. Right? And if you look at the expenditures on children who are in preschool, what you can see in the right-hand graph is that expenditure in rural areas is so low. I don't see how on earth they can provide a quality of education to preschoolers in rural schools, which urban children take for granted. It's a ratio of around about $250 per child in urban school and about $40 per child in rural school. They cannot be given the same quality. Remember, all the education that they've been saying all the time, it's not just about access to education, it's also about the quality of education you get. And you can see, of course, the top 20% in urban areas, they spend $600 per child in preschool. Now, primary education, now, I know you've seen reports coming from Ministry of Education which say that everybody is in primary school, 100%, you know, enrollment and all that. But you only have to walk around in Lambasa, Nandi, Rotoka, and Suva and see all the little kids running around, you know that they're not in school. And they should be. And this data here from the Bureau of Stats, which is not looking at estimated numbers, you know, at the national level, and looking at the Ministry of Education numbers for enrollment, this is actually going to households and saying, have you got children of this school age, primary age, are they at school or not? So this is survey actual data, which I will gamble any money you like on, that is reliable data, not stuff that's coming from the Ministry of Education. 5-6% of kids are not at school, and again, the same problem, how much are you spending on your primary school kids at school? In rural areas, it's a very low amount compared to urban areas. And when you look, of course, at what the elite families spend on the children at school, it's $900 per child. And here we are in urban areas, we're spending about $200 per child. And in rural schools, we're spending only $100 per child. And you can have a decree saying that, you know, you must only charge this amount per child and all the rest of it. In the end, the rich parents will find a way around it and spend the money on the children's education. Now, there is another problem here, which is that secondary and tertiary education. Secondary one has gone out of the window. I deleted it while I was trying to make the presentation short. Anyway, but this is equally telling, right? Percentage of 19 to 21 age group at school. If you look at it, in the bottom 40% of the population, right? Bottom 40%, only 30% of this group are at school, 70% are not at school. Right? So what are they doing if they're not at school? You know, you can guess whatever you like, right? But you know, it's very, very clear that you know, when our children get to that age group, if they have a policy that they should be going to some tertiary institution like FNU, learning a certificate, a qualification, a diploma qualification, but they're not there. They're absolutely not there. And even at the upper rural level, right, you can see that, 80% of those people, 80% of the people are not at school. Then, expenditure, again, now this is something that the donors, you know, should really think about, because the focus of donor effort in the past has always been at primary and secondary education, but at tertiary education, which is what you need to, where you need to go if you want to get a certificate or diploma, by the time, you know, you go up to expenditure per person at tertiary education, even in the urban areas, you're now spending $5,000 per kid to go to tertiary education. Now, which family in Fiji earning, say, incomes of just around the basic case poverty line, which is about $10,000 a year, how on earth can they afford to pay $5,000 for one person, one kid to go to tertiary education? And if they've got two kids, they'd have to pay $10,000. They'd have nothing left for food, rent, or anything else. So, I mean, you know, it's good to have a policy of fee-free education at primary school, and every kid must get into secondary school, etc. But in the end, people with secondary education still are not able to earn the kinds of income that will take them out of poverty. You've got to get them into a tertiary education level where they're getting a certificate and diploma, which may even allow them to emigrate. At the moment, if you look at the percentages, something like about 60% of our kids, you know, who get to that age are not able to enroll for whatever reason. Now, I don't believe that it is to do just with not passing exams. I think it's also to do with the fact that to go to tertiary education, you need money. You need to spend $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 a year. And a lot of our families simply just do not have that. So, you know, there is a big problem over here.